Hey everybody, welcome to another week here at the TirolerInn. It's a cold one again. Seems to be a recurring theme here. I'm trying to finish the floors this week, getting all the old subfloor out and putting the new one in. Julie's gonna help tomorrow, so maybe tomorrow we can get all the subfloor installed. And today I wanna rip out as much as I can. You can see here I have some, brick on the ground. I'm actually needing to take two more layers of that brick off of the old fireplace or chimney stack that we had here. I need to do one more now. I already did two. You can see here I have some old bricks on the ground. I took already off camera two layers of brick off, and now I need to do at least one more so that I can put that joist in there where the chimney was before, so that we have a continuous flow here too. So the next step is to take out all the different boards here. And as I'm going, I will also fix issues, take out the nails right away so that I don't have to walk on all the joists just to get everything fixed, especially on like rotted spots and stuff like that. I'll try to fix it as we are going. So you might be wondering why I put extra nails in here. Actually, when they built this, they actually never nailed these because they put the floor on right away, so they didn't have to. It was all fixed and wouldn't rack anymore at that point. So I'm just, now that I'm taking the entire floor off, I wanna just fix those to the studs so that nothing racks as I'm putting on the new floor and everything's gonna sit exactly the same as it was before. Plus, it's gonna have much more strength from the new subfloor. Sunday afternoon, and I got my favorite special guest visiting today. Judy's gonna help me take out the rest of the kitchen floor, and I'm excited that we can actually work together sometime again.
Here's another area where the wood is rotten. You could see all the way outside. And so we definitely want to get that fixed. So we've seen in a lot of these old houses that have been repaired that they've just covered things up, and we've seen even in this house layer after layer on top of issues or problems, and it's like if they're covered they're just going to go away. But we want to make sure that our finished product is all even, one level here in the floor. And that if there's any problems in the floor where there were holes or where we found that the subfloor in some areas was pretty loose, that we get that all taken care of so that what we put back, so that when we put the pine flooring back on, it'll all be solid and even, and we know that there's nothing underneath that we have to worry about that's just been covered up. One example was back here in the corner. We found as we were cleaning out some of the old insulation that you could actually see right out the wall of the house, so it's wide open over here. We'll have to get that taken care of. We have a lot of work to do on the siding, we know, but we'll definitely make sure and get those areas closed up.
I think that's it for this week.
Bye, see you next time.
Bye. Need some foot extension. Hello.
You're the one who wanted to do this crazy.
All the way out? Which way?
It zoomed in right now. That's better.
Okay.
You're silly.
Is this that?
No. Stop. Ah! Yeah, you could help. Go ahead.
Okay. Gotta
do
it again.
No! Yeah. Who's talking? Who's saying it? You say that's all for this week, and then I'll say bye.
Okay.
Okay, ready?